So guys, a few days ago, we had the opportunity to sit down with AMD at their Markham offices and talked about a bunch of new things. And while some of them will need to stay locked away, a big part of our time was spent discussing their drivers. So for those of you who've been following the channel for a while now, you'll notice that this is a video that we do every year around the same time. As a matter of fact, last year on December the 12th, we posted our video on the Adrenalin Edition drivers, and you can actually check it out right over here. But basically, AMD tends to roll out major updates on a yearly basis, and so here we are in mid-December, and boom, a massive overhaul for Radeon software. You see, many years ago, AMD was known for having amazing hardware, but they were held back by some pretty poor drivers. Now, they're on a mission to deliver the best software possible and move the perception of gamers away from the old thought that AMD's amazing, but their drivers really suck kind of thing. So now they want to deliver day one support for new games and also want to add a lot more features to their GPUs. So let's discuss a little bit more about that right after a message from our sponsor.
Hi, I'm looking for a case.
Well, look no further. I got this beauty.
The H700i by NZXT. With all steel premium frame, with a side of tempered glass to beautifully showcase any cooling adventure you might pursue, and cable management system that you wish you had earlier. All this lit up with integrated RGB lighting and built-in fan control. The H700i. This one's for you.
Oh, I'll take it.
Now I know what you're all thinking. What's performance like on these new drivers? Well, according to AMD, they made some pretty big steps since the original Adrenalin Edition drivers that were launched about a year ago. So this is a chart that they provided us, and there has been some significant improvements, but remember, this is a year of development. But you can also see some of these titles like Battlefield 5 and Assassin's Creed Odyssey weren't even around when the Adrenalin was first introduced in 2017. But with AMD's focus on day one driver support for new games, there's a big performance improvement over you using older software. Another big focus for AMD is their project ReSX, which targets popular esports games like Overwatch and Fortnite for special treatment. Basically, they're aiming to boost FPS while also lowering response times and improving 99 percentile frame times. But what does this all mean in real-world testing? Let's check it out, but before that, I want to mention how these were tested. Basically, I took AMD's 18.6.1 drivers, which were launched in June, and I'm comparing them to the Adrenalin 2019 at 1080p resolution. It should be interesting. So as you can see that even with some older games like Overwatch and Destiny, there are performance boosts, but the bigger ones come with Battlefield 5. Basically, the newest game received day one driver updates that weren't around back in June, which is pretty cool. All right, so enough about performance since there's a lot more to talk about and I don't want this video to run close to the 20-minute mark again. But I do wanna mention something really quickly. AMD has been adding a lot more features to their latest update, and that's primarily because of the community feedback that they've been receiving. So they've been hosting, the Radeon team has been hosting regular feedback sessions on Reddit, Twitter, and even they've been pushing surveys to their drivers so that as soon as you know they get those results in, they actually start developing the new features. Honestly, guys, the most interesting thing about these new drivers is what AMD is bringing to the game streaming space. While you can already use the Relive features to stream your gameplay to services like Twitch, YouTube, and Mixer, Relive game streaming service allows you to wirelessly stream your PC games directly to your phone or tablet over a Wi-Fi network. So a quick overview before we show this in action. Basically, AMD game streaming is meant to offer exactly what Valve's Steam Link and NVIDIA's GameStream technology do, but it doesn't require another box like the NVIDIA Shield to run. The only small hiccup is that it isn't officially compatible with Android TV solutions, but if enough people ask for it, they'll look into porting it over. So ask for it, guys. According to AMD, since this uses the asynchronous compute engine within GCN GPUs, latency is better than on other solutions like Steam Link. The only performance cut will be between 1-3%, which is basically the overhead from AMD Link running in the background. Setup is actually pretty easy too, at least that's the way it worked at AMD HQ. The first thing you do is download the AMD Link app on either your Android or iOS device, scan the QR code to pair with your PC, and select the game from the Game Explorer tab. It's then a simple matter of actually playing, since AMD gives you the option to either use on-screen controls or a Bluetooth controller. In theory, it should be possible to get this set up with your TV, provided you have an Android-compatible wireless controller. Supposedly, Bluetooth keyboard and mouse could work too, but we didn't get to test that. Now, considering this is a first-generation technology, I thought it worked pretty well, but there were a few streaming hiccups and artifacts every now and then. The nice thing is that you can even change the resolution in case your GPU is having trouble streaming at your device's native resolution. We're actually going to cover this a bit more soon, so stay tuned for that. If there's anything specific you want to know, let us know in the comments down below. One of the other interesting features rolling out in these new drivers is Radeon Game Advisor. Now, it might not sound as amazing as game streaming, but let's check it out anyways. So basically, this analyzes performance as you play a game. So here I am playing Battlefield 1, and I can press Alt-R to bring up Radeon Overlay. This overlay tool was launched with Adrenalin in 2017, and it brings a massive number of tools right at your fingertips in a game. So in the Game Advisor tab, you can see that after it quickly tests performance of my system, in this title, it'll recommend some changes to either improve frame rates or give better image quality. I think this feature will likely appeal to people who quickly want to optimize their game and get playing instead of spending a while going through the whole trial and error process. It's also probably a pretty big deal, or it's probably going to be a pretty big deal for novices who are just getting into PC gaming and might not be able to use all the options that they encounter. So back to other few options in the overlay features, AMD has added a centralized display tab that houses options like the ability to turn on FreeSync and Enhanced Sync. There's also an option to control colors in game as well. Luckily, the Radeon overlay will remember all of these settings for the next time you launch a game or a specific title. But remember that some monitors require you to turn on FreeSync on the panel before it's enabled in AMD software. Wattman is the overclocking utility for AMD cards, and it's now in the overlay as well, with the ability to overclock or automatically overclock the GPU and its memory. That's pretty cool since it allows you to create a game-specific overclocking profile and test it immediately rather than just using the global settings. Finally, the performance tab is still around, but it has a whole new makeover with a ton of customization options that includes adjustable colors, modifiable columns, and a lot more. It's a pretty cool area to show and log in-game performance metrics. Speaking of Wattman, it got a shot of Adrenalin 2 with automatic GPU and memory overclocking, as well as dynamic GPU undervolting. There's also better control for fan curves. The RX Vega GPUs get a few targeted improvements too, with fine grain adjustments for DPM states and even some very serious memory tuning options. Next up is a small but pretty improvement to FreeSync to HDR. You might remember Dimitri had some issues with HDR displays blowing out bright colors and scenes in some games. Well, AMD is now adding auto tone mapping into scenes so they keep the detail when HDR is enabled. That's a huge relief, and I'm hoping NVIDIA does the same thing since their cards experience these same problems. The last thing that I wanted to cover is something that's a bit small when compared to some of these other huge items. It's extended support for virtual super resolution, or VSR, upscaling on 21:9 displays. It was actually one of the most requested items on AMD surveys, so they ended up adding that as well, which is awesome.
Improve your workflow with Stream Deck Mini by Elgato, giving you 6 fully customizable LCD keys for macro commands, hotkeys, app launches, media control, and a full array of customization for OBS, Twitch, XSplit, and more. Check out the Stream Deck Mini down below.
So there you guys have it. I know it was a lot to cover, but believe it or not, there were a bunch of changes in these new drivers that I personally wasn't able to get to. But I'm really curious to test out some of the new features like game streaming, for example, and see how that plays out with my smartphone. But what we're really seeing here is AMD continuing to develop their drivers and bring some really cool, exciting features to the forefront. I just hope that their hardware makes a real comeback as well. So that's it for me. Let me know what you guys think about the new update from AMD. In fact, if you own an existing AMD GPU, would you consider take advantage of some of these new features that AMD has rolled out? Love to know in the comments down below. I'm Ibar with Hardware Canucks. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to check out some relevant content over here. Subscribe to our new Boot Sequence channel. I'm signing off, and I'll see you guys in the next one.